So hello everyone and very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of government schemes. In today's session guys, we are going to talk about one of the most important schemes from the Ministry of Rural Development, and the name of the scheme is Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen, right? Now remember, the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen is being implemented by Ministry of Rural Development, while its urban part is being implemented by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So we will discuss the urban part later. In today's session, we are going to talk about the Grameen part, the rural part. Okay. So let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, if you want to ace the NABARD examination this year, you can join the live class course, which is already going on. The classes are being taken by Suraj sir and Anuj sir for ARD and ESI respectively. And if you want to have the all-round preparation, you can download the Anuj in the Lab from the Google Play Store, right? And yes, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join the Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. All right, so let's talk about this scheme. So first of all, if I talk about the objective. So as I always told you guys, that the objective can be easily derived from the name of the scheme. So what is the name of the scheme? It is Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen. Forget about Pradhan Mantri and Yojana. Just focus on these two keywords, which are Awas and Grameen. What is the meaning of Awas? It's housing. And what is the meaning of Grameen? It's rural. So what is the objective of this scheme? The objective of this scheme is to provide housing for all in the rural areas of the country. Hamare desh ka jo rural areas hai, wahan pe logo ko ghar dena is the objective of the scheme, to provide houses to the rural households of the country which do not have the houses, right? That is the objective of the scheme. Earlier, the target to achieve this housing for all under this scheme was the year 2022, but recently it has been extended up to March 2024, which means the period of implementation of this scheme is up to March 2024. All right. I hope the objective is clear. The objective is to provide housing for all the rural households in the country which do not have the access to the proper houses, right? And talking about the ministry, of course, we are talking about rural India. We are talking about housing in the rural areas of the country, which means the ministry should be the Ministry of Rural Development, right? It is headed by Mr. Giriraj Singh. It is headed by Mr. Giriraj Singh, and his Lok Sabha constituency is Begusarai in Bihar. And he is also the Minister of Panchayati Raj, of course, right? So I hope the objective and ministry is clear. Moving ahead to the eligibility. Now, who are eligible to get the benefits of this scheme? First of all, do remember this, to identify the beneficiaries under this scheme, socioeconomic caste data are used. SECC data will be used for identifying households who are genuinely deprived of houses, right? Number one. Number two, and all the houseless and household with 0, 1 or 2 rooms with kaccha walls and kaccha roofs are eligible. Now, what is the meaning of household with zero room? Household with zero rooms means where the bedroom is not separated with the living room. Basically, the household which has only one room, ab wo bedroom bhi hai, living room bhi hai, kitchen bhi hai. So that is considered as household with zero room, right? Under the definition of this scheme. So any household with zero room or one room or two rooms, and even if the household has one room or two rooms, but that is a kaccha room and with kaccha walls, then in that case also the beneficiary, the household, is eligible to get the benefits, right? And the priority is given to the SCST or minority communities. SCST or minority communities ko isme priority di jati hai, right? So that is the eligibility criteria. Now there are some automatic inclusion criteria and some automatic exclusion criteria, right? So there are 5 automatic inclusion criteria. Any household which lies within any of these 5 criteria, then that household is eligible. Number 1 is household without shelter. Number 2, destitute or living on alms. Number 3, manual scavengers, primitive tribal groups, and legally released bonded laborers. So if any household lies within the criteria, lies within any of these 5 criteria, then that household is eligible, right? And there are 13 exclusion criteria, and you don't have to go into the details of these 13 exclusion criteria. That is not required for the examination, because in a scheme document hum sari cheeze nahi kar sakte. That is एक्चुअली नॉट पॉसिबल, 150-200 पेजेस का डॉक्यूमेंट होता है, सो वी कांट डू एवरीथिंग राइट. सो 13 एक्सक्लूजन क्राइटेरिया आर देयर. नाउ व्हाट इफ अ हाउसहोल्ड डज नॉट लाई इन एनी ऑफ द क्राइटेरिया, लाइक द हाउसहोल्ड डज नॉट लाई आइदर इन द ऑटोमैटिक इंक्लूजन क्राइटेरिया और इन द ऑटोमैटिक एक्सक्लूजन क्राइटेरिया, देन इन दैट केस how will the government decide the eligibility of that household, right? So for that, these are some of the criteria. Number one, household with no adult member between age 16 to 59. Then female household, female headed household with no adult member between the age group of 16 and 59. Household with no literate adult above 25 years. Then household with any disabled member and no able-bodied adult member in that household. And finally, landless household deriving the major part of their income from manual casual labor, right? So, ये सारे criteria हैं to get the benefit of this scheme. इनमें से अगर किसी में भी कोई household lie करता है, then that household is eligible to get the benefits, right? Benefits क्या है उसकी बात हम आगे करेंगे. Now there is a role of gram panchayat as well. So what is the role of gram panchayat? See, gram panchayat works at the grassroots level. So the very first and very major role of gram panchayat in this scheme is to help in identifying the common land available for allotment to the landless beneficiaries. जो landless beneficiaries हैं, ठीक है, मान लो कि घर बनेगा, तो घर तो land पे ही बनेगा. अब मान लो कि किसी के पास land भी नहीं है, तो in that case what will happen? तो of course land allot करना पड़ेगा. So for लैंड अलॉटमेंट, अब वो आइडेंटिफाई करना किसका काम है? ग्राम पंचायत का, राइट. इसके अलावा द ग्राम पंचायत विल आइडेंटिफाई फैमिलीज हु आर अनेबल टू कंस्ट्रक्ट हाउसेस ऑन देयर ओन, एंड देन ग्राम पंचायत विल हेल्प देम इन कंस्ट्रक्टिंग द हाउसेस. एंड फाइनली इट विल हेल्प द बेनिफिशियरीज इन अवेलिंग बेनिफिट्स ऑफ वेरियस स्कीम्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, लाइक दीनदयाल उपाध्याय ग्राम ज्योति योजना, प्रधानमंत्री उज्ज्वला योजना, एटसेट्रा, राइट. So these are some of the roles of Gram Panchayat. Now talking about the audit. So there is a provision of audit by CAG as well. So all the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen accounts are being audited by CAG on or before 31st August of next year, right? And there is a provision of social audit as well, which is being conducted by Gram Panchayat once in a year. Saal mein ek baar social audit bhi hota hai, jo ki kaun karta hai? Gram Panchayat karta hai. All right. So I hope this is clear. And now let's talk about the things that you have to remember. So among all the things that you have to remember, the very important thing is the launch year. And this scheme was launched in the year 2016, right? 2016 mein ye scheme launch hui thi. Moving ahead to the funding pattern. So it has very basic funding pattern, jo ki generally har scheme mein hota hai, but yahan pe ek thoda sa exception hai. For union territories, it is 100% by Government of India, but for not all union territories, there is one exception, and that is union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. For Jammu and Kashmir, the funding pattern is 90:10, 90 by Government of India, 10 by Government of Jammu and Kashmir, jo ki banegi abhi hai nahi. Northeastern states to Himalayan states, that is Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand, and one UT of Jammu and Kashmir, it is 90:10, and for other state it is 60:40, jo ki generally har jagah hota hai. And this indicates that this scheme is a centrally sponsored scheme, right? Centrally sponsored scheme hai ye. Moving ahead to the allocation of scheme fund. So, jo paisa diya jata hai, wo kahan jata hai? So, 95% of fund, which includes 4% for administrative expenses, is given to states or UT for construction of houses. Construction of houses ke liye jo fund use hota hai, wo hota 95%. And this 95% includes 4% administrative expenses as well. While the rest 5% is reserved for special projects. If there is any special project, then that 5% reserve fund is used, right? Now, what about the targets? So, the total number of houses to be built by 2024. This should be 2024. Earlier, it was 2022, but now it has been extended up to 2024. The total number of houses, 2.95 crore, right? The phase 1. In the phase 1, the target was 1 crore, which was completed in financial year 2019. In the phase 2, the target was up to financial year 2022, that is 1.95 crore, but due to COVID-19, kyunki construction ruk gaya tha, isliye jo target year hai usko extend karna pada, and now the target year is 2024. So in phase 1, 1 crore was the target was completed. इन द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2019 बिफोर द डेट कंप्लीट हो गया था वो, एंड नाउ इन द फेज टू अप टू 2024, अप टू मार्च 2024 है इनफैक्ट, द टारगेट इज 1.95 करोड़, एंड देयरफॉर द टोटल टारगेट इज हाउ मच, 2.95 करोड़, राइट? सो हाउ मेनी हाउसेस आर टू बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड, 2.95 करोड़ इन फेज वन, 1 करोड़ इन फेज टू, 1.95 करोड़, ऑल राइट? आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. नाउ वट टाइप ऑफ बेनिफिट्स, कितना पैसा दिया जाता है घर बनाने के लिए? सो इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द प्लेन एरिया, सो इट इज 1.20 लाख. If I talk about the hilly, difficult areas and left-wing extremism district, it is 1.30 lakh. Willing beneficiaries can also avail loans from financial institutions up to 70,000. 70,000 तक का लोन भी लिया जा सकता है financial institutions से. And 12,000 extra is provided for construction of toilets under Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen. Right? 12,000 rupees for construction of toilet is also provided under Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen. Alright, so these are some of the benefits which are being provided to the beneficiaries under this scheme. Do remember this, plain areas 1.20 lakh, hilly difficult land LWE districts 1.30 lakhs, 70,000 ka loan liya ja sakta hai and 12,000 for construction of toilets under Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen, right? And these are some of the other key features. So if anyone asks you that what is the minimum house size, जो कि इसके अंडर बनाया जाता है, सो दैट इज 25 square meter इंक्लूडिंग अ डेडिकेटेड एरिया फॉर हाइजीन कुकिंग. 25 मीटर स्क्वायर का एरिया मिनिमम होना चाहिए घर का. इसके अलावा प्रोविजन ऑफ 90% or 95% डेज ऑफ अनस्किल्ड लेबर वर्क अंडर मनरेगा फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ हाउस ओवर एंड अबव द असिस्टेंस, ओवर एंड अबव द हाउसिंग असिस्टेंस, एंड दिस असिस्टेंस अमाउंट्स टू ₹18,000. हाउसिंग असिस्टेंस के लिए जो मिल रहा है उसके अलावा 90 to 95 days का मनरेगा वर्क भी दिया जाता है टू द बेनिफिशियरीज वर्थ टोटल ₹18,000, राइट? एंड द लाइटनिंग, द इलेक्ट्रिफिकेशन इज ऑल्सो प्रोवाइडेड टू द हाउसेज थ्रू दीनदयाल उपाध्याय ग्राम ज्योति योजना, विच इज अ स्कीम बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पावर. एंड फाइनली फ्री एलपीजी कनेक्शन इज प्रोवाइडेड टू प्रधानमंत्री उज्ज्वला योजना ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल गैस, राइट? सो बेसिकली देयर इज अ कन्वर्जेंस ऑफ वेरियस स्कीम्स. And all these schemes, through all these schemes, the benefits are provided to the beneficiaries of Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen, right? So that's it about this scheme, guys. And if I talk about the Union Budget 2022-23, so for Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana in total, I am talking about Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana in total, ₹48,000 crore is provided. Okay? Not individually for Grameen I am talking about. In total, including urban and Grameen, 48,000 crore rupees is the budgetary allocation for this financial year. Alright, so that is about the scheme. And now, ek baar jaldi se revise kar lete hain ki kya kya cheeze hain iske under. So the objective of the scheme is to provide housing to the rural households across the country. The target here is March 2024. Ministry is Ministry of Rural Development. The beneficiaries are identified through SECC data. All household with 0, 1 or 2 rooms with kaccha walls and kaccha roofs and houseless people are eligible to get the benefits. SC/ST and minorities are given priorities, right? There are 5 automatic inclusion criteria, 13 automatic exclusion criteria. But if any household does not lie in any of these criteria, then they are identified through these 5 criterias, which are these. There is a role of Gram Panchayat in allotment of land, in identifying the beneficiaries and in helping the beneficiaries in construction of houses and to provide them with the benefits of other schemes of the Government of India, right? There is a provision of audit by CAG, right? All the PMAYG accounts are being audited by CAG of India and social audit is being done by Gram Panchayat once in a year. It was launched in 2016 with very basic funding pattern for UTs, except Jammu and Kashmir, 100% is by Government of India. 90:10 for northeastern states, Himalayan states, Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh and Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. For other state, it is 60-40. Jo paisa aata hai, wo kaise use hota hai? 95% is for construction of houses and this 95% includes 4% of administrative expenses and the rest 5% is reserved for special projects, right? And targets. In the phase 1, the target was 1 crore. In the phase 2, that is up to March 2024, the target is 1.95 crores. So the total number of houses which are to be constructed under this scheme is 2.95 crores. And talking about the benefits, so in plain areas 1.20 lakh, in hilly areas or LW affected areas it is 1.30 lakhs, 70,000 loan can be taken by the beneficiary and 12,000 for toilet construction. Minimum size of house is 25 meters square and there is a convergence of various schemes as well. All right. So that's it for session today. I hope guys the scheme is clear. And if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And I will see you in the next session on Monday with a brand new government scheme from the Ministry of Rural Development. All right. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.